Hey, what's up guys, Steven here, and this is my review of the Seek Thermal XR extra range thermal imaging camera for Android devices. So let's get directly started.
So the Seek Thermal XR comes with pretty good specs, and 20 degree field of view, adjustable focus, and pixel resolution array of 206x156 pixels, a wide range of temperatures to measure, from minus 40 degrees Celsius to 330 degrees Celsius, the frequencies below 9 Hz, long-wave infrared 7.2 to 13 microns, 12 micrometers pixel pitch, vanadium oxide microbolometer and chalcogenide lens, magnesium housing and a protective waterproof case. So this is also what you can find inside the box, and all that for the low price of $299. So one question you'll probably ask is, how far can you see in total darkness? Now with the extra range you can see very far, so you can detect heat up to 1800 feet. You can recognize objects up to like a little bit over 400 feet, and you can identify objects, so you definitely know what is that object, up to around 250 to 300 feet. Now with the compact version, which has a wider field of view but not such a good range, you can actually detect heat up to 1000 feet, and the identify range is like the recognition range on the compact, and also you can only identify objects up to 180 feet on the compact version. So the extra range version which we have here is very good for objects which are very far away, but also because of the adjustable focus for very extreme close-ups, for instance of electronic circuits.
So guys, now you will ask me, what can I do with a thermal camera? How do I benefit from it? So actually you can do a lot of things. You can use it to observe wildlife. For instance, if you're a hunter, then you can observe animals in complete darkness, or you can even spot animals at daylight, so it's a pretty cool thing. You can use it to actually spot intruders which are breaking into your home. You could also use it for sure for other things, for instance to check out heat loss. Now if you want to improve your home, you want to know where does the heat go out, usually around the windows, and you can spot the heat with the thermal camera. You can also use it to detect electronic shorts, so if there's something wrong with the electronic wiring in your home, for instance. Now, if you want to check out motherboards, heat dissipation of a processor to see, for instance, how hot smartphones get, this is also one of my use cases. The next thing are water damages in your walls. So if there's hot water or cold water dripping, if there's any leak, you can spot it with the thermal imaging camera. So you can't see those things with your eye, but you can see it with the Seek Thermal XR. So one of my possible use cases, actually the main use cases, I want to build something like a thermal scope for my AR-15. You know, thermal scopes are very expensive. They can go up to like 5, 6, even 10 grand, and this is way too expensive for me because I just want to probably spot some animals and that's it. And what I will do actually is I will use a smartphone holder for the rail on the AR-15 and then just hook up the thermal camera with an USB extender. And that's a very good alternative, for instance, for hunters to any thermal imaging camera, because those thermal imaging cameras, they are probably very handy and also feature a display and a rear scope, but they're like 10 times expensive, and it's really worth it for me to use the Seek Thermal XR. So that's pretty cool, and you will see also footage on the shooting range probably this week. Alright guys, so this is what you can do with the Seek Thermal XR, and now let's go and let's check it out.
So for sure, this camera is available for iOS and Android. Now you need at least iOS 7 or 8, and also on Android you need at least Jelly Bean, so 4.3.1. Then also there are some other limitations. So the faster your phone is, so for instance with the latest generation of the iPhone, the experience is way smoother because the whole processing is done by the integrated processor of a smartphone. That means if you have a very low budget Android phone, then probably it will run not very smooth. So it really comes down to your phone. Also, if you have the Android versions, if you want to get it, you need a smartphone which is OTG compatible. So if OTG is not supported by a smartphone, the camera is not properly detected and it won't work. So make sure OTG is supported. The iOS version for sure comes with a Lightning connector, and the Android version ships out with a micro USB connector. So if you have a smartphone with USB Type-C, you will need to use a full adapter, otherwise this is not working. With cheap USB Type-C connectors, the camera won't be connected, just like on my OnePlus 2. So there we go, now let's have a closer look at the product itself. As you can see, it comes in a pretty nice looking box, and there we have the product. So this small thing which you can see here, yeah, that's the thermal imaging camera. So this is what replaces a 10 grand thermal imaging camera. For sure the resolution is probably not as good and it doesn't come with a display, so you still need a smartphone, but yeah, I still think it's absolutely worth it. So it comes here with the Seek Thermal logo, as you can see on the front side, and also here we have the big lens. Now the difference to the compact version is that you can rotate the lens to focus, so this is really important. Now you can also focus, for instance, on very close objects, so even though it's the extra range version, it doesn't mean that it's bad for close-ups. So it's not so easy to spot things like with the compact version, because the compact version has a wider field of view. That means you just grab it, and even if you don't know where's the thing you want to measure, you will see something on the display. Here you really have to know where you're pointing the camera at. Alright, so let's have a closer look at it. You can see here the lens, and the lens is coated, as you can see, so it looks like a mirroring surface. Make sure you don't touch it. It's a little bit easier here to touch the lens, and so to protect it you also have here this waterproof protection case, which is pretty good to carry it around. Okay, so let's have a look here at the bottom side. As you can see, it's just made out of some kind of magnesium plastic case. I'm not really sure about the exact material, but it looks pretty durable. So here's the micro USB connector, and this is how you connect it, for instance, to an Android phone. Now, if you buy the iOS version, for sure you will have a Lightning connector. So you could also probably use an adapter from the Lightning to micro USB. I'm not really sure about that. But those adapters you're going to use, they need to really actually forward all the lanes. So if it's, for instance, only a power adapter, it won't be detected by a smartphone, I guess. So the only bad thing about this micro USB connector, which you can see here, so you can't really rotate it. Like, I would like to get it out and place it in there again with, for instance, 180 degrees upside down. Because some smartphones, they just have an upside down micro USB connector. And you want the camera to face to the backside of the smartphone, so just like a rear camera. Now, on some smartphones I have here, it just faces the display side, so my face, and this is really pointless and useless. So that's the only bad thing. You really need then an adapter, so you could use, for instance, also micro USB cable extender, but it really needs to fully extend all the USB wires which are inside of the USB connector. So that's the only bad thing so far. Now regarding the size of the case, I think it's a pretty good size and it fits actually all my smartphones. Just the only bad thing is, as I've mentioned, that the USB connector can't really be rotated. But except of that, I think the design looks very good, and also the focus here, so there's some grip around the lens and it's really easy to adjust the focus, but you have to play around a little bit to get the hang of it, because it's not so easy to get a sharp image. So ladies and gentlemen, now let me quickly show you how to connect the Seek Thermal camera and how to use it. Now you need the Seek Thermal application, which you can download in the Google Play Store or in the App Store on iOS devices, and it's absolutely free, so if you just want to check it out even without the camera, you can download it. Okay, so make sure that OTG is supported by your smartphone before you buy the camera, just as I've mentioned before, and then actually all you have to do is just plug it in. So there we go. There's a micro USB port here at the bottom of this device, and you see, if the USB port is just like in this direction, it will work with your smartphone. Doesn't matter if it's at the top, at the bottom, but if it would be in the other direction, you would just face your face and or the display. Now, as you can see, you have to grant access. So the Seek Thermal application has to grant access to the camera, and there we go. Let's hit the OK button, and we're now here in the application. You will hear that the camera ticks sometimes. So your camera is not broken, I guess that's the shutter, so it adjusts something and makes a strange sound. But this is absolutely normal. Alright, so here in the left bottom corner, here are the settings of this application, which I just want to show you before I show you a quick demo on what you can do with it. Now here we have the temperature units, so you can switch here between Kelvin, Fahrenheit and degrees Celsius. So I'm from Europe, so I'm using here degrees Celsius. Here we have different color themes, for instance, if you want to use different colors here for the thermal image, you can use it, you can change it here. Okay, then here we have image preferences, so aspect ratio, first of all, probably everyone wants 16:9. You can have customized watermarks, so date and time, location and the Seek logo. Let's go back here. So sorry, this phone is sometimes not really responsive. And metadata, image smoothing is currently here on. And let's go back here. Then here just about and help us to improve. So that are basically the main settings of this application. And now I want to quickly show you a quick demo on how to use this application. So we'll just have a look at some things outside, and there we go.
Now here's a quick live demonstration of the thermal imaging camera. So just imagine that's your house. Now probably your house looks different or better, but anyway, you want to see where the hot air goes out. So let's say you want to improve the house, you want to get new windows, and you don't know if your windows are actually tight and if the heat stays in, and you want to check it out with the thermal imaging camera. Also, there are a couple of chimneys on the right side, as you can see. So you don't know if they're hot or not, but yeah, with the thermal imaging camera, you can see it. And we'll now just quickly test it. So let me grab my device and let me show you what you can see, what you can't see with your eye. Okay, now there we go. Let's have a closer look here at the building with the Seek thermal camera. It's now attached here to my smartphone. Unfortunately, I have to hold the smartphone upside down, so with an USB port at the top of this device here, it would be better, because then also, for instance, the front-facing camera is more near to the Seek thermal camera. Now you will ask me, why the front-facing camera? Yes, I've told you, you can also use split-screen mode. Sometimes it's really hard and you never know what you're aiming at with the Seek thermal, so you can use the smartphone's camera, the rear camera, to actually see what you're aiming at. And we can quickly try it out. So split-screen mode works if you press the button here in the right top corner, and as you can see, I cover the rear camera, so this is a little bit bad. But I can now just here switch between the images and also do here a split screen, like half of the image is the rear camera of the smartphone and half of the image is the Seek thermal camera. Okay, so let's end the split screen mode because, yeah, here it's actually pretty easy. We're far enough away from the target, and also here you can see, for instance, the chimney is really hot, so you can definitely spot it. Okay, but let me now show you some of the things you can do. So for instance, you can take a picture. You just have to press the shutter button here, picture saved on this device here. You'll find a couple of sample pictures, sample videos on our website, so make sure you check it out. Sometimes your picture will look very blurry and not really sharp, so what you have to do is you have to focus the camera. You can do it by rotating the lens, and yeah, you really have to find the correct spot, and that's sometimes a little bit hard. Mostly on the right outside and left outside it gets even more blurry, so something in the middle usually does the job, except of extreme close-ups and objects which are very far away. So let's aim at the chimney here. For instance, if I rotate the lens here to the far right side, as you can see, it's very blurry. It could be everything. It could be a rocket. It could be, I don't know, a spaceship. But if you just gently rotate the lens to the left side to get more to the focus plane. Okay, guys, so let's say we found the correct focusing spot. What you can do now, as I've told you, you can take a picture or you can also shoot a video. And that's pretty cool. So what you have to do is you have to switch here to video mode at the bottom. So here's photo mode with the shutter button, here's video mode with the record button. All you have to do is just hit the button and now it records the video. Sometimes it will say the video can't be saved, but this is just because I have here a smartphone which is not really powerful. But with all the latest smartphones, so pretty good Android phones or an iPhone on the iOS version, it should be no problem at all. And there we go, let's hit here the stop button. You will find some sample videos on our website, but also some in the video just here right now. But yeah, for sure, that's not everything you can do. So you can also switch between different modes. And here in the right bottom corner, we actually have here the mode selection. So what you can see here, we are currently here in normal mode. So regular thermal image, and basically it's like the auto mode on your camera. It will detect everything within the proper range, but also for sure, if you know what you're searching for, there are other options where you can tweak it. For instance, here we have the spot. So in spot mode, you get something which looks like a crosshair in the middle of the screen. Also under the crosshair, you can see, for instance, the temperature in degrees Celsius. So this shows the temperature here around the crosshair. Now, you can see the blue color here, it's like 13 degrees Celsius, but for instance here, near the chimney, so if we actually place the cursor here directly on it, you will see the temperature, the surface temperature of the chimney, which is around 30 to 35 degrees. Now, with one hand, this is really hard to do, but if you do it with two hands, you can actually measure the temperature pretty accurate and also really fast. Now, that's the spot mode. Now high and low mode is pretty cool, so basically it's just like normal mode, but you get two indicators showing the highest and the lowest temperature.
For instance, near the chimney, we have 40 degrees Celsius, and here in the air, so a bit over the roof, we have like 12 degrees Celsius. So that's like a temperature difference of almost 30 degrees Celsius, and that's pretty cool, so you can definitely see what's hot, what's cold, and the difference between that. Alright, so we're now here in threshold mode, which can be very useful if you already know what you're looking for instance, specific temperatures. Like here on the bottom side, you have here above, equal to, and below. If you're looking for any temperature, for instance, below a certain level, like 0 degrees Celsius, if you, for instance, want to have a look at ice and you want to get rid of all the other stuff in the background, then you can go here to below and you switch it here, for instance, to like, let's say here, 15 degrees, and then you can see here, for instance, which temperatures which are very close to 15 degrees here in blue. Here's something which is hotter, like here, for instance, the chimney, and that's also equal to. So if you're looking for a specific temperature, if you're looking for something which has 14 degrees, so here around the chimney, for instance, and yeah, here, so something around the window, and here's also above. That's pretty cool too. So if you're looking for any temperature above a certain level, let's say here, for instance, 13 degrees, you can see gently here, slightly around the chimney, and yeah, then just the chimney here in white. There are also different color modes, so here's in color palette, I hope I pronounce it correctly, and here at the bottom you can see there is black and white, there is iron mode, there is cool mode, so with more blue tones, there are those other modes, like this is called amber, it's like in Call of Duty, the heartbeat monitor or something like that, and you see it has pretty cool color schemes which you can apply to your preview picture here. And the only bad thing, so I don't quite understand it, is if you go back, if you go out of the color scheme, I'll just go back here to black and white and the usual theme. So this is something I don't quite understand. So as you can see, it's still, it doesn't save the theme here for me. Probably it's meant to be like that, so please don't count me if I'm wrong. It's still a very new device to me too. I haven't had a thermal imaging camera before, but I think it's very, very cool. Alright, so as you have seen, you can take pictures, you can record videos, and here are the settings which you have seen before. So that's basically everything we can find in here, and that's what we can do with it, and I have to say it's pretty cool. Now you will see some examples, for instance, from my car, and let's discuss this a little bit, and after all this we'll come to the pros and cons about the Seek Thermal XR.
Now to check out the pictures and videos you've recorded, you just go to the gallery of a smartphone. There you'll find pictures in the Seek Thermal folder, and there's also a video folder, so I can quickly show you that, and here you can see the videos also with preview, and I have to say, they look pretty good, so we can just check one of them out, and as you can see, the playback is really smooth on the smartphone, but also you did see something on the computer, so absolutely smooth experience here with the Seek Thermal XR. Yeah!
So we're now here at the end of this review of the Seek Thermal XR thermal imaging camera for Android devices. So here comes my conclusion about it. Now a little bit expensive, but versatile and downright cool. The Seek Thermal XR is a great little gadget with seemingly endless use cases. So it's just amazing how much technology you get for the low price of around $299. So it's well built, has a solid design and comes with a good carrying case. But yeah, there are some things where I'm not so happy with the Seek Thermal. First of all, the USB connector. So if you have a smartphone where the USB connector is upside down, the thermal camera actually just faces your display or basically your face, and then you can just take thermal selfies. That's not so useful. So then you would have to use some kind of USB adapter, which you can get on eBay. But you have to make sure that it's a full USB adapter and not just power only, otherwise the camera won't work. The next thing is that the focus is a little bit tricky, so you need to get the hang on it and how to focus correctly. And yeah, last but not least, it really depends on your smartphone. If you want to have the smoothest experience, you need a very fast processor, because processing is just done by the smartphone. So the faster your smartphone is, the better and smoother is the thermal experience on your smartphone. So there's a small learning curve, but once you get the hang of it, you can take thermal images anywhere you go with the Seek Thermal. So it's a great little device for the price, really okay, and I really love it. You can find links down below in the description if you're interested in this device. So for the price, it's really good. Thanks for watching this review and see you very soon in the next one and in the follow-up video. Make sure to check it out and subscribe.